Hello, this is the best of the Clone Wars, and I'm here today with the host of Clone Wars Weekly.
Hello.
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 Okay. Aren't you going to introduce yourself?
They know who we are.
Oh, yeah, so
duh.
That's one thing we've got done. Okay, and now, isn't included in an emotional way, we are going to go over our favorite episodes of this season. Yeah, so overall it's been a great season, and I think it might be my favorite season.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, so
probably for me too.
Yeah.
Same, in a very psychological way, except for season 3 was my favorite.
Q? Why are you here?
Yes, Quentin, why are you here? Didn't Corey say that he was not going to let you be on cast for Best Of?
I am
he
Echo.
He snuck in the back door when we first started.
Well, it's too late to care. You're out of it, okay? So, let's begin. Okay? Now, this is going to be a little more because there are multiple episodes we can go over, so we are going to talk about, our favorite 3 episodes.
Keep it brief, remember.
Yeah. Okay. I shall begin. And then Taronin, and Batil, then Q.
Who wasn't supposed to be here.
Okay. And my third favorite episode of the season had to be The Gathering. Yeah, I really loved this episode. It didn't need action to be great, and that's what I like about it. I expect huge explosions and I see a great episode, but The Gathering, it was a nice change of pace. It had a great story and it didn't need action at all to be great. It had Ahsoka, it had Yoda, it had the younglings who were all great. And yeah, plus it taught us a little more about Star Wars in a way, how they kept the crystals on island, and it was just so intriguing and nice to watch. Yeah. That's a brief way of summing it up.
Keep it brief.
And number 2, The Lawless. Okay, The Lawless. So we all know what we're going to talk about in this one. Yeah. Emotional deaths, deaths that we can be happy about, and Darth Sidious. Okay? Yes. The conclusion of the Maul arc. I have to say, this was an explosive conclusion I would have expected from a season finale, but they decided to show it now. But anyway, okay, and this particular finale. Oh, not finale, but
GG, bro.
In this particular episode, there's a lot going on. There's Mandalore being run by Maul, and there's Obi-Wan finally making an appearance in this arc. And there's Darth Sidious coming into the Clone Wars.
And Echo!
Echo was not in this episode!
Yes, he was!
I must have missed that part.
Yeah, so a lot to notice about. I cheered when Satine died, I got sad for Savage, and
Wait, hold the phone! Did you just say you cheered when Satine died?
Yeah.
But you were sad when Savage died?
Yeah.
What the?
Are you sorry? Your next last choice, Corey.
Okay, so since I'm not going to be able to finish my speech on the Lawless. Okay. Now, my favorite episode of this season is also my favorite episode of Clone Wars in general. A Necessary Bond. Yeah, this was a conclusion to a great arc. Yeah, my favorite arc. And it had so many great things about it. It had Ahsoka, Grievous, Hondo redeeming himself, the Slave One, an alliance between Ahsoka and the pirates, the droid takeover. Everything was just so wonderful in this episode. It was just so friggin' awesome, and oh my god.
You know what it needed more of?
What?
It needs more Gnody.
I knew you were gonna say that. Yeah. Yeah, so, everything about this episode seemed great. I would have expected, an episode like this to be the season finale, because it has so many things packed into it at once.
You still talk talking about this?
Yes, and that fight with a second Grievous.
It
fight ever.
Moving on. Yeah. Just move on.
Yeah. And Necessary Born, my favorite episode. What else can I say about it?
You can say nothing else, please. Nothing else.
Okay, Renan's your turn.
No more grease open. Just.
Circus fun for everyone.
Sorry, I'm a bit tired after breaking Cad Bane's neck, so I'm going to make this short. I'm trying to say this for all the new viewers out there.
Don't worry.
In our wonderfully popular podcast.
Shh, don't be like, well, you know.
All right, basically, my third favorite would be Point of No Return. Great characters and big freaking explosion. Episode 2 of my favorites would be The Wrong Jedi. Beautiful finale and really, 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 really good storytelling, aside from Barriss. And number 1 would be The Freaking Gathering, which is one of the best ever and the obvious best of the season!
Wrong. So wrong.
It's opinion, you foolish little droid.
My opinion is fact, meatbag.
You're a bullsack, Batil.
Batil. Yotun meat droid bag. That's it.
It's bucket of bolts, you useless meatbag. Okay, so I'm going to make this short and sweet, too. I'm not going to go like Corey and go on some big tangent like he did. All right, my 3 episodes. I got Shades of Reason, got Sunny Day in the Void, got To Catch a Jedi. To Catch a Jedi, that's what it's called. So, Sunny Day in the Void, due to the awesome character development between Whack and Gascon. I love how obscure and random the episode was. It's made for a really fun episode, and the setting was brilliant. Shades of Reason. We get more Katan goodness, Death Watch. They're foreseen as liberators of the people, which I love. He's in Lawless. The fight between
Pre. There too.
Was he? I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay, Jeeves was in there too.
The background.
Jeeves was in there, and the fight between Pre Vizsla and Darth Maul was awesome. And Darth Maul just totally beheads Vizsla. I love it, Katan. Yum. And then there's To Catch a Jedi. Ventress. What more need be said? Go ahead, Quentin.
Okay. Eminence. Wait. Secret weapons! And missing in action!
And this has been another fantastic episode of Best of the Clone Wars. This is the Raging Rodian Ronin.
This is Batil, saying goodbye. The meatbag exterminator.
And I'm quick! I don't know who I am!
And Q never gave us reasons why he did it.
Yeah, you'll never know why!
And someone say the ba-da. Or
da-da!